Hello, this is Let's Play FB Games with episode 148, part 1 of Survivor Series. So I'm on this menu because the second match has some mystery guys in it for Degeneration X's team and also Diesel and Big John Studd's team. So without any further ado, apologies. I just remembered the difficulties on Legend. I need to put it back to hard because I did a match on Legend when I was offline. Well, not offline, but not recording, is what I'm meaning to say. So if the game could hurry up and load, then we can get underway properly. If I press the right buttons, that would also help. But anyway, let's go. Survivor Series, everybody. Okay, so the Ascension versus Titus Owen Young and Darren O'Neill. The prime time players. Primetime players. And I've sort of changed a few stipulations in some of the matches, so you might see some different stipulations for different things, so there you go. Oh, yeah. One last thing before we finish. Ah! And here come their opponents. Millions of pounds. I had to delete a few apps to make room for this, so think yourself lucky. Because I only had about 59 minutes, but now I've deleted a few apps, I've got 1 hour 15. So I should have more than enough time to finish part 1. I hope. Make a move, we get money, I can pull. Fucky poo. Pooing poos. Then pooing and pooing even more. NXT Tag Team Championship! Primetime players versus The Ascension. The Ascension successfully defended their NXT Tag Team Championships at Hell in a Cell last month, sadly only on the pre-show, against the Million Dollar Corporation. This time they get, they get on the actual show. Albeit the first match, but it's the actual show nonetheless. The Ascension versus the Primmy Timmy players. So, how good do you think part 1's going to be? On a scale of 1 to 10. I wouldn't expect too much, and I'm joking, it's going to be good. We've got two tag team title matches. We've also got the Survivor Series elimination match between Degeneration X and the Mystery Guy, as well as Big John Studd, Diesel, and their Mystery Guy, which isn't really that much of a mystery, but neither of them are really mysteries, but nonetheless, we've also got, I can't outside dive for some reason, Connor, okay, also, we've got the Dean Ambrose Invitational. If you haven't heard of that, he's trying to beat people to get his shot at the WWE Championship, and if he beats enough people, he may get shot at TLC or maybe the Royal Rumble. But that's not the point. The point is, Dean Ambrose will have a mystery opponent, and he will have to beat them. And I'll give you a clue: the mystery opponent was actually at last game month. Not last real month. The guy was at last month's pay-per-view. and he was in a Hell in a Cell match. So, if you can guess, if you can watch previous videos while you're watching this one, if you're on, if you can guess who it is, then well done to you. I will do a giveaway, but I don't have enough money. I don't know how you work giveaways, though. Primetime players early advantage here. Which is a good sign for the Ascension. The Ascension want to return, and they want to return, well, dominantly. The Ascension and the Million Dollar Corporation had won a hell of a match on the pre-show. That was about 17 minutes long. Hopefully this match will be as long. By hopefully, I mean, I don't mind it being as long, but that means I have short time for the rest of the matches. I mean, it probably won't be as long. It depends how long it takes me to win or lose. Nice sneaky move there. Oh, but Darren Young catches Connor anyway. Connor needs to make a tag. I'll try and try to anyway. Also, I give Triple H and Shawn Michaels their finishing maneuver, the double team one. The super kick and the pedigree. Pedicure. Hard seems a lot harder than it was before. I don't know why, it just does. For some reason. I don't know. But anyway, after this, I've worked out I've only got 72 more episodes to do, and then I've done 2K14 Universe Mode, unless I continue it, or maybe I'll do 2K15. Maybe I'll just stop Universe Mode altogether and do other games. So maybe I'm just going to become a live stream. If I get a live streaming capture card, I might just become a live streaming channel and just mess about on live streams and stuff. Maybe I won't even do a serious series. Although my sister, my sister's boyfriend is getting her a game called Rayman Origins. I keep trying not to say oranges, so Origins, yeah. And I don't, I've not heard of that before. I've heard of it, but I've never actually seen gameplay. And apparently it's good. And if you've seen gameplay, then if you like it, then good, because that might come on my channel. If my sister is getting another Xbox controller, I believe. So I've only got one at the moment. So my sister's getting another one. And then, if she does actually get another one, and everything goes to plan with the capture card and everything, you might be seeing some Rayman Origins on my channel. And my sister said I could probably get about 100 episodes or something like that, so. There you go, I fucked up your move, didn't I? Nice move by Connor. Cheap shot, though. Now Victor going to take advantage. You know the powerbomb Victor does for his signature? I meant to say that as his finisher, but I forgot. I was just out for a meal with family, so that's the reason this is getting recorded so late. About freaking... Oh, wow, O'Neill. About 25 past 10, or whatever time it is now. I've got an hour left to do, so that's going to take me about to nearly half 11. That means my parents are going to get pissed off because they were going to bed about that time. My room's right next door, which doesn't help. If my room was downstairs or something, that would be so much better. Because then I could just record at any time, and you won't be able to hear me as well. I mean, they'd be able to hear me, but not just as much. My room was downstairs, it would be pretty cool, except my room's upstairs, like everyone's. Looks like I'm going to have to tag in Connor. Connor versus O'Neill again. Oh my god. Are you freaking serious? I pressed X. What the hell? And now I pressed LB to ring escape. I clearly pressed... Oh my. Connor. Belly damage. Nice takedown. A win in this match is huge, as it wins the team who wins the tag team championships for NXT. Fuck sake. I don't remember how difficult it being this difficult. Victor, get involved. So is Darren Young. Victor takes down Darren Young. Connor taunting. Victor distracting Titus O'Neil. Now Connor's going to take advantage. Roll up. One count, no. Oh no. Power slam. Cover, one count. Victor needs to get in his teammate's corner because I want to tag him in. There we go. These two teams going right at it. Had a good match so far. It's been pretty even, I'd say. I mean, maybe O'Neill and Darren Young have had more freaking control, but let's ruin the double team again. Connor distracts Darren Young, but Darren Young still might just hit a move. Hit a $1 million move. Has those $1 million swags and those $1 million shoes. And I'm apparently not getting a signature ever, even though I should be having one now. I don't know why I'm going to be on a signature, but you know what? There you go. Oh, the powerbomb gets reversed. It's a good job I didn't put it as a finisher then. Finisher now. Victor has. Seriously, O'Neill, you're going to lose by count if you don't watch out. Wow, I'm damaged. Oh, I'm so damaged. Cover. Take advantage. I'm just waiting for corners to get back in the corner. Such a helpful tag partner. Victor. Still beating Darren Unknown. What a tool. Okay, never mind then. This is amazing. The primetime players will win by DQ. I apologise for that. I really do. That wasn't intended. That definitely wasn't intended. You can see I was trying to free him. I was trying to hit the full Nelson slam. At the same time, Victor was trying to hit the uppercut. So, I apologise for that. And, yeah. So, next match. Let me cover the screen. Apologies for the ending of that match. That was pretty terrible. I'll admit that, because, well, I didn't mean to freeze them. I was trying to hit my finisher, but then, oh, let's let Victor hit his uppercut on the outside. That wasn't the planned spot, but we'll do it anyway. But anyway, let's go to the next match when the screen goes to the Survivor Series thing, which is there. Big John Studd. I had to involve him somehow. On the way to the ring, from Los Angeles, California, weighing 367 pounds, Big John Studd.
Oh, the WWE Universe letting them hear it.
The only person who actually likes Big John Studd in this game, and the only reason I really like Big John Studd is because of the heart punch sell that his opponents do. When he delivers the heart punch, it's just quite funny. You'll see if he delivers the heart punch. I think you've seen it on my universe mode before. I believe I've done it quite a few times.
Dear. From Detroit, Michigan, weighing 317 pounds,
Big Daddy Cool. Diesel.
Almost 7 feet tall. This guy's dangerous in every sense of the word.
Oh, I'll give you a clue about who the guy on this team is. The guy, Victor in the last match had a signature that I wanted to hit but couldn't, and the guy who has this as his finisher. So there's your hint. And you've seen Victor's signatures before, I'm pretty sure. So if you get that, then well done. If you don't, then not well done because you shit. No, I'm joking, but well, it's not pretty hard. It's pretty easy to get. Here he is, the wealthy Texan. We haven't seen this guy in quite a while. I can't remember when we actually last see him. But he's back tonight. He's back to team up with Big John Studd and Diesel. He's the mystery guy. Don't ask why he's the mystery guy. I just didn't know who else to put as the guy to be the mystery guy. But I also can't explain why I have the guy on DX's team as the mystery guy either. But I guess it's really to cement his face turn. Which I don't know if it's a good idea or not, but anyway. Anyway, here comes Degeneration X. Meow. Bow to the masters. Break it down. Here they are.
Triple H and the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. Oh, listen to this place. Everybody's on their feet. I love this atmosphere.
Generation X. Generation! Know who you're talking to. Well, you better get used to the way the ball bounces. I see what you get in pinches and ounces. That's a bracelet, man. Break it down. Degeneration X! Don't ask. Don't ask, really, to ask. I'm really hyper. So, you think you're a big man? We'll try it like you're a lot. We'll try you. Yeah, we'll try you. Here he is. I apologize. I just really didn't know who to. But he's definitely face. Actually, now I think about this, this is a bad idea, but it's already on TV, so we'll have to continue. I mean, not TV, video. So I'll have to continue, and we're already 20 minutes in, and I'm not restarting again. Especially after I've done a match. Now, by again, I tried recording once, and it messed up. So, Yokozuna. The crowd don't know how to react to this big man. Come on, Hogan, you big man. Well, Hogan's going to be fighting tomorrow because, as you know, I do my pay-per-views on two different days. So, on this part is, well, I've already said, but this match, then the Dean Ambrose Invitational, and then the tag team title match between Hollywood Chavs and Punk and Daniel Bryan of the NWO. And then on the next part, we'll have Razor Ramon versus Drew McIntyre. Just a normal match now. It was last man standing, but it's not now. And then we've got Randy Orton versus Ric Flair versus Goldberg versus Edge for the World Heavyweight Championship in an elimination match. And then the main event is Bret Hart versus Hollywood Hulk Hogan in a last man standing match with a mystery referee. So, I don't know if it's actually a good pay-per-view. It's probably shittier than the real Survivor Series. I apologise for that. But you know what? Who gives a shit? So remember, this is elimination. This is going to be quite a long match then. I just remembered this is elimination, so I just realised this is going to be quite a long match. Quite a lengthy match. Nonetheless, let's continue. Oh, wow. How dare you knock my friend off? I'd say it sort of makes sense, because if you remember, you probably won't, and you probably won't want to remember. But ages ago, I think it was, I believe, Hardcore Heaven, Big John Studd and Yokozuna had a match against each other. Battle of the Giants, I believe it was, or something. Some shitty idea I had for ECW, because I couldn't get actual ECW guys. My universe used to be terrible. It still is, but that's not the point. The point is, it's going to get better. WrestleMania is going to be amazing. Especially if I can live stream it, then that'll just be the bee's knees, and its arms, and its legs, and its freaking rest of its body. That's probably going to be quite a long video, the WrestleMania. It's probably about 4 hours or something, like a real one. I don't know how many matches I'm going to include on there. I've got quite a few planned, so that means probably quite a few on the game. And now, D-Generation X double teaming on their traitor, Diesel. Diesel said he left because he never wanted Triple H involved in the first place. He just wanted to be him and Michaels. But Michaels took offense to that because Triple H is his best friend. And now Michaels and Triple H are teaming together and Diesel's been left alone. I forget who the hardcore champion is now. Oh yeah, I remember now. Stone Cold. Stone Cold Steve Austin beat Dolph Ziggler this past SmackDown. So if Dolph Ziggler loses his title tonight as well, then that's going to be two title losses in the space of 2 days, and that's not going to be great. Speaking of Dolph Ziggler, he won the Intercontinental title back in TLC. Luke Harper's probably going to get a rematch tonight where he wins it back, which is so stupid. Because the cat decided to keep the title on. But anyway, TLC, it looked like a pretty good pay-per-view. Judging by the results, I'm saying this. I'm guessing the Bray Wyatt, I'm so glad that the Bray Wyatt and Dean Ambrose match main evented. And I'm so glad that Bray won. The only thing I'm not glad about though is that Cena beat Rollins. I wanted Rollins to win. I thought there would have been more interference and Rollins would have won. But no, Roman Reigns had to come back and help Cena win. I mean, I like Roman Reigns. I really like him. I really wanted him to come back. But why did he have to help Cena? Why didn't he turn heel and help Rollins? That would have been a lot more interesting. I mean, he's done all these freaking satellite interviews playing as a babyface. I'm going to call them babyfaces from now on, because everyone just calls them babyfaces, not faces. And then, well, I understand that, because that means he'll have to probably come back as a face, a babyface. But what would have made it more interesting is if he'd come back as a heel, like turned on the fans, that like he attacked Rollins, then attacked Cena. That would have been pretty cool. And it would have left fans wondering. That would have been even better. Anyway, I'm just rambling on now just about TLC. TLC looked like a good pay-per-view. I'm so glad Miz and Mizdow didn't lose their tag titles to the Usos. I'm so glad that I'm trying to think of other matches on the card. I'm so glad that I wish Eric Rowan had won the stairs match. I'll be honest. Big Show's just a ass now. Not an ass, but no one really appreciates Big Show anymore. What I'm trying to say is no one likes Big Show. Well, I don't anyway. But that's not the point. The point is TLC looked pretty good. Or should I say TLCS? TLCAS, because it was tables, ladders, chairs, and stairs. But anyway, it was all in all, it looked pretty good. And because I'm cheap and I can't afford the WWE Network, and I also can't afford pay-per-view channels, I'm gonna have to wait till it comes out on YouTube to watch it. But nonetheless, I don't care. I'm gonna see Raw tonight. I probably get most of it from that anyway. Wait, is it no DQ? Oh shit, I didn't make it no DQ. It was meant to be no DQ. I would have made it a lot more interesting, but nonetheless, let's continue. So, I hope you're actually going to enjoy this match. If you're not going to enjoy this match, feel free to skip, because I can't think of many people who would actually like this match. Belly to belly. JBL kicks out, but now what? Oh no, JBL reverses. Triple H suplexing everyone in sight. Pedigree by Triple H. Count it. Oh, Big John Studd just saving it. Looks like Triple H wants in. Gotta stack Michaels in there. Nice flying forearm by Michaels up top. Starts away with Ultra Verso. Michaels is actually going on a roll. He's on a roll here. Till that point. To the point where he gets eliminated, doesn't he? Nice punch by Diesel. Ref got taken out. Not a wise move by the team of JBL, not JBL, yeah JBL, Diesel and Big John Studd. But anyway, continuing with the match now, I'll stop rambling. Sorry, this match is going to be so long, but you know what, who gives a shit? I mean, I give a shit, but that's not the point. Come on, ref! Get your crack more like you've done quicker, for fuck's sake. Here comes a fucking jackknife. Oh, I thought I was gonna reverse that. Yoko, are you just gonna do nothing? Triple H couldn't have broken up that pin any easier. Fuck's sake. It said I reversed that. This is bullshit. What's happening here? What's actually going on here in this match now? Because I'm lost. I'm a little bit perplexed. I'm not tagging you back in, Yoko. Actually! Actually, never mind. Spine Buster! Thank What the hell? It's just pissing me off now. This is just going into aggressive rape. No one's getting eliminated. This was a bad idea. Fuck off, Stud. No, it doesn't. No, it freaking doesn't. That's right. Right, tag him. Oh my god. Dribbles, get off Michaels. Right, I'm going to stay as a legal man. Because that's probably their best strategy. Especially if I want to tag someone else in. Okay, never mind. Okay, yes, never mind. Oh my god. Teammates! I have got no freaking teammates. Who bloody help me? Then again, if I get the first elimination, it'd be pretty quick after that. But if they get the first elimination, though, won't they? Oh my god, you utter twats. You utter twats, you almost cost Michaels the match. You almost got him eliminated. Okay. So we're going for a hot tag. Right, guys, I'm going for a roll-up pin, so please stop them. Thank you. No, okay. I can't do the hot tag now because they're freaking in the fucking goddamn ring. Abby and Wyatt's pressing there. Thank you. Fuck off! I wasn't even running towards you, Diesel. This is getting annoying. Your call, get out the... Oh my god. This is just turning into a mess now. Get off. No, you're going to do a hot tag. Thank you. Triple H. Knocks down Jibbles. Knocks down Study Boy. Spinebuster. Fuck off. Michaels, you stay there, please. Fuck off. Yoko, move. My god, this is... I'm getting really annoyed with this match now. Michaels, get on the fucking apron ahead of Yokozuna, please. Oh my god, this is fucking pissing. Oh my... Yokozuna, get off the apron. Michaels, get on where Yokozuna is. Do you know what? Fuck this. Let me just get my finisher reversed instead. How about that? Yeah? Yeah, okay. There we go. Problem solved. Fucking hell. Ah, my control disconnects. Woo! Fuck off, Stud. I did a move. Just drop kick the ref, Michaels, that's fine. I hope this is over soon as well, because this is fucking in line now. Right, Michaels is the only one who can do a roll-up, so let's tag him in. Yoko, get your fat ass off the apron. Now, Michaels, right, on the apron. Tag him in, there we go. Oh, great, now they've got the freshest man back in. There we go, now, break it up. I mean, don't let them break it up. This is fucking match. I'm really just considering getting all my team disqualified because this is pissing me off now. I mean, it's only been going 15 minutes, but still. Still. Could Diesel just fuck off, please? Thank you. And can Yokozuna, can you just piss off, please? Let me do this on my own. I can do this. I'm not freaking amateur. I want to do it with a good move or a roll-up, so I'm going to have to end it with a roll-up. Or not. A roll-up. That's a question. This is just a mess now. This is just a complete, utter mess. I know, I've just thought of a good way. If his legs are damaged enough, turn around. Woo! Shit, it's not damaged enough. Yeah, they're still not going to help me. How helpful. Yay, and then my controller goes off again. Woo! This is just into a fucking shit match now. Why do I have this idea? It's pissing me off. Diesel GTFO, mate. Michaels, double team. Wait, I've got a comeback again. Okay. I was going to say I'm not going to be denying my comeback again, but apparently I am going to be. Diesel, piss off, seriously. Diesel, piss off, sir. I'm freaking done. See you later, guys. Fuck off, Chibbles. Triple H has almost no action in this match. Let's just continue with destroying with him. Even though I pressed the air button before he did. Let's just continue anyway. Finally, finally. Michaels. I've got a plan here if my team decide to break the pin up. I've not decided to stop them from breaking the pin up. And if Big Stud goes along with it. Or not. As the case may be. Fuck off with your signature. Michaels, get up first. Come on. Come on, Michaels. Michaels. Thank you. And ref can count. No, I can't. Fucking God. Actually, that's probably a good idea to do damage to his legs. That's why didn't I have that idea? Let me out then. Let's get JBL disqualified. They broke it up again, god damn it. Let's tag in Triple H again because Yokozuna's never in the right fucking place for a tag. No, you're not getting out of here. You ain't getting out of here, man. Oh, shocky docky. Figure four time. Seriously, John, can't you just tap the frick out? Oh my god. And the controller goes off again. I'm getting sick and tired of this now. This was meant to be a really good pay-per-view with no fucking bullshit. No, it's... Oh. Joe, I think it's time for a little bit of bonsai. Or maybe not, as the case may be. Michaels, get on the apron. John. Stop. Big John, stop. Michaels, corner, now. Oh, take the long route. There we go. Always good. Don't Yoko, get in. Oh, okay, maybe not. Okay, maybe not then. Fine, tagging Jibbles, he's just as damaged. And when I eventually get up. If we could get Yokozuna on the apron, or Michaels on the apron, we could... I want to turn another pedigree, because I've hit two of those already. Wait, Michaels... Oh, yes! Yes! Yoko, you better go split this up. Get the pin. Thank you. Yes! One down, finally. Oh my god. Oh, was that so difficult? Was that really so difficult? Super kick out of nowhere. Michaels may get a second pin. Oh, elimination comes in fast and heavy. We coming in fast and heavy. Why the fuck am I not Shawn Michaels? I never even changed the guide. Follow me right now. Okay, okay, this is it. So you eat, sleep, piss and shit. Alright, come on. It's been going 20 minutes now. Sorry, Yoko, but you're just shit. Actually, that's a pretty good plan. Michaels is going to get all the pins.
All the pins.
You know what that means. I need to tag in Yokozuna for a bit, because he's barely been in, and that sounds pretty shit. Oi. Can my team split the pin? Never mind, I'm Triple H. Oh my god. Yoko, yes. Yoko's getting tagged in, Mike, I'm afraid. Let me get... Oh my god, let me tag in Yokozuna, please. Thank you. Get him, boy. Since Yokozuna's never really been in this match, we're going to have to... He really hasn't been in the match much, has he? I've got a finish I want to try, but if it don't work, then fine. I couldn't care less. How is Yokozuna hurt? He's barely been in this match. See what I mean? Point proven. Oh. Right, I want to try something here. If Michaels fucks this up, then Michaels fucks this up, but... He's gonna fuck us up, isn't he? No, Michaels. Wait! Oh, my fuck. What did I tell you? Mess it up. Fine, we'll do it this way then. We'll just... It's the shittiest way to end the match, but who gives a crap? This match has been going too long anyway. Unless he kicks out, then, yeah. Ref takes his time counting. And Diesel kicks out. If you're going to hit your finisher, Diesel, just do it already, because I really cannot be bothered. This means we've got a much shorter other two matches, anyway. Boy, actually, fuck it. I know how we're finishing. Figure four, motherfucker. And of course he's going to break out of that because he's triple freaking Nash. Triple Nash. Okay, his legs are on red. Oh, will you stop disconnecting, you stupid mother freaking controller? The tag team match is going to have to be shorter now because this match is just taking way too long. Okay, I'll do this then. Let Triple H get elimination, or maybe not. Oh, the knee! Oh my fucking god. Oh no. Jackknife are coming. I hit the RT button, so I'm gonna break this up. Maybe not. Oh, okay, never mind. I think it's only fair that Yokozuna gets the elimination, since he's freaking... I was joking about Michaels getting all the pins, by the way. It's only fair that Yokozuna gets the elimination, since he's done absolutely nothing. Or tries to get an elimination anyway. It depends how long Diesel wants to hold out for. Seriously! It's getting annoying now. You're dead, okay? You're dead. Oh, wow! Fuck. Oh. Seriously. Right. You ain't hitting that shit finisher. I can't believe everything that's transpired thus far. It's been so physical. Oh, did you see that? Diesel's a freaking fighter. Ow, what an elbow. What an impact from that kick. Joe Watt's gonna finish it. A shitty superplex. Fuck it. Okay, we'll just tag Triple H in then. Never mind about what my plans are. Do you know what? Michael's apron. Michael's fucking apron, you twat. Thank you. Oh my god, off the top rope. You're not freaking Michael's. Michael's Michael's. Flying forearm. Okay, that's not flying forearm. Who gives a shit? Let's go. Please. Diesel. Please, 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 please. No! This is my house! No, I'm joking. Seriously, this is getting annoying. Joe, we've got to triple team him. Here's what go down! Stay the frig down! Alright, yeah. Final hurrah for Diesel! And the controller disconnects as freaking Diesel's about to tap out. This has gone shit, hasn't it? Flicking. Oh! I'm so pissed off now. I'm so annoyed. I might just turn replays off altogether for every match. That was more painful than it had to freaking be. What a time. That was so shit. Honestly, I thought it was going to be a lot quicker. I apologise for it not being. I'm so sorry. I hate that freaking match now. That's going to go down in history as one of the shittiest matches ever. I might just have to do the next... I'll do Ziggler and... I'll do the tag team title match on the next part because I'm not going to have time otherwise. I might have to do a three-part Survivor Series. Yeah, I'm just going to do a three-part Survivor Series. Tag cannot be fucked doing any more matches now. After this one. Obviously. I don't want to rush this match, and I don't want to rush the tag title match, because the tag title match is sort of a main event. Here is the opponent of Dean Ambrose. A good match. The thing that annoys me the most is I'm going to have to do a three-part Survivor Series now. Fucking hell. Seriously, if that match had just been up to 40 minutes, I would have done it. I would have been fine, and the controls just connected. Woohoo! So this pay-per-view has gone to absolute shit. I hope you're actually enjoying these matches, because I swear to God, I'm freaking not. No, the first match was okay. The second match was just a rape fest. This is going to be a good match, though. I can feel it in my waters. Dean Ambrose, Chris Jericho. I was going to play as Jericho and get Ambrose to win by disqualification instead of time for the tag match, but I thought, nope, that's a shitty ending. We want a freaking good match finish, too, so... Apologise, you're going to have to see a three-part. It's going to be three matches in the first part, three matches in the second part, and then the main event will be on the third part of its own. Because I'm not doing 3-2-2, because that means I'd have to make two mid-card sort of matches longer. So, the WWE Championship is so important, it's going to get its own match. I didn't want that match to be almost half an hour. I wanted that match to be about 20 minutes at most. I wanted it to be about 15 minutes. It is indeed a holiday tradition. We're having so much fun at Survivor Series. The real-life Survivor Series matches, some of the 5-on-5 ones are shorter than that. This is why I should have it on medium, on normal, sorry. This is a quick pace match. The other thing I wish I had done Ambrose is resiliency, which I think I'm going to put on him. Because he's really resilient now, and so is Rollins. And I guess Reigns as well. The whole Shield are going to have resiliency, fuck it. He's got a schoolgirl. Oh, damn! I'm joking. They're just having a roll up off these two guys. There's a point you just get sick of it after a while. Not stopping until Jericho kicks out, so... There you go. Nice takedown by Ambrose. Cover. Trying to go for another cover, try to wear Jericho down, that's a good idea. Chris Jericho in trouble here, Dean Ambrose. Oh wow! That's good, that's gotta do it, that's gotta do it. Ambrose going for the cover. Two count. Now Jericho, backbreaker. Enziguri. Kick to the arm. Followed by kick to the back. Jericho's taking over here. Big move off the Czech Republic. Neckbreaker. I was actually thinking of doing a steel cage match, but steel cage match for one of the matches, but I'm not gonna. Okay, never mind. Looks like I'm not hitting my signature then. Hey. Oh, he's finishing now, okay. Headlock driver! I'm not calling it the Dirty Deeds anymore because now the Dirty Deeds is a different move according to WWE. Going for a cover! Kick out by Jericho, 2.5. Dean Ambrose has taken over in this match. And Jericho kicks out. So Jericho's gone from fighting for the World Heavyweight Championship to fighting Dean Ambrose in an invitational match. And now he's going to get beaten. Oh, I almost got beaten there. If I got beaten, I would fucking not even finish the recording. I would have just shut my phone down and broken my Xbox. No, I'm joking, but yeah, we're almost at an hour. Takedown by Ambrose. Into the corner. And now Jericho going for a drop kick through the ropes, sort of thing. That thing. I don't know what you call that. And now he's on a sig. Jericho doing the walls on the outside, so it doesn't really matter, but I'm going to try back out anyway, so that wasn't much damage. I don't want to go back in the ring because he's got a finisher. Wow, I'm actually pretty hurt. Control, please don't disconnect in such a good match. Jericho really gonna be that guy. Back into the ring now. Jericho couldn't capitalize quick enough. There's no way I'm going top rope. He could catch me in a code breaker. Kick out by Jericho. Oh well, if Jericho wins, it's a lesson for Ambrose to learn. Nice reversal by Ambrose though. Nice move. Right, I hope this finish works, because if it doesn't, I'm going to be so pissed. It's not even meant to be that. Headlock driver. And now going for the running knee. Taught to him by Mr. William Regal himself. And that's going to do it. Ambrose picks up the win. Well done to Dean Ambrose.
Here's your winner, Dean Ambrose. An emotional victory here tonight.
And oh man, what a battle! Anyway, that's going to be the end of part one because, well, I'm out of time. I'm not going to be able to fit the tag team match in within 11 minutes. So I hope you've enjoyed part one and I'll see you next time for part two and part three probably. Bye bye.